Hey guys, what's up? This is Nikhil, your TweetPad instructor, and in this After Effects tutorial, we will learn how to create a digital and modern looking lower third in After Effects. So without any further ado, let's dive in into After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in After Effects. So let's start by creating a new composition. Let's rename this to main comp. So let's rename this to main, because this is going to be our main composition. 1920 into 1080, 30 frames and 10 seconds looks good enough, and hit OK. So the first thing that I'm going to do is create a rectangle, and to do that I'm going to select the rectangle tool and just double click on it. So it's going to create a rectangle. We don't need any strokes, so we can set this to 0, and we need the fill, so you can set it to any color that you want. I'm going to go with something like a gray. We can color this up later as well. So let's rename this to base, because this is going to be our base shape. Then I'm going to go into rectangle 1, rectangle path 1, unlink the size, and I'll set this to around 900 pixels. And this to, let's go with 140 pixels. So we have something like that. So this is going to be our base of the lower third. So let's go into transform rectangle 1 and skew this up by 35%. Just like that. And now what I can do is I can just lock this layer up and select the pen tool. Now we don't need the fill this time, so I'm going to set this to none and hit OK. And I'm going to set the stroke to around, let's go with 70 pixels. And we can just zoom it in, and holding shift we can just create a straight line or stroke just like that. So you can change the color to a different one so you can see it more properly. And then we can just rename this to anything that you want. I'm just going to rename this to plane. Then go to plane properties. Let's make some room right over here. Go into contents, shape 1, and transform shape 1. And skew this up by 35% as well. Just like that. And then we can just align this with our base shape. So you can just, you know, select the layer and use the arrow keys just to be a bit more precise. Alright, maybe a bit to the right. Yep, almost perfect. And now what I can do is go into add and add a trim path so that we can animate the stroke just like that. So let's set this to 0, create a keyframe, make sure it's at 0 and create a keyframe. Go to 1 second maybe and set the end property to 100. So now we have something like this. And then what I can do is just duplicate this up by hitting ctrl D on the keyboard. So this is going to be the plane 2. And just place it just like that. You can also use the arrow keys just to be a bit more precise. So we have something like that. I think that is looking good. We can hide the base shape. We can also delete it if you want to, but we will need this later on, so I'm just going to hide it up. So we have the shape 2 as well. So I need to change the direction of the animation. And to do that, I'm going to hit U. So we can see the keyframes. Get rid of the end property keyframes and create keyframes on the strat property. So I'm going to set this, or maybe I'll just leave it to 0. Go to 1 second and create a keyframe on the start property. Go back in time. I'm going to set this to 100. So now we have something like that. So we are done with the base animation. Let's select the layers and hit U so we can see the keyframes. Select the keyframes and hit F9 to ease those keyframes. Go to graph editor, and if your graph editor doesn't look like this, make sure you're working in the edit speed graph and not in the edit value graph. So I'm going to select these keyframes and drag this handle just like that to create a curve something like this. So now the animation is going to start in fast and then settle down slowly. Looks pretty good. Yep, that is looking nice. So our base shape is ready. And now what we can do is we can start creating some really cool looking accents to make it that, no, to give it that really nice and digital look. So to do that, let's turn on the base shape. Now we don't need the fill, so I'm going to set this to none. And set the stroke to around, let's go with 2 pixels. Then go into rectangle 1, rectangle path 1. And just increase the size a bit, just like that. Okay, looks good. Maybe a bit. Yep, that looks good. So now what I can do is go ahead and add trim paths, and we can animate the path. So basically we can just hide this control layer so we can see the stroke more properly. So we can animate the complete stroke just like that. So now what I'm going to do is go to around, let's go to 15 frames maybe, and create a keyframe on the end, start, and the offset. And set the offset to maybe around, let's go with minus 150. Okay, so now we have three keyframes. Let's select the layer and hit U so we can see just the keyframes, and go right over here, maybe around 1 second and 20 frames, and set the end property to somewhere around there. Maybe let's go with 25, I guess, and set this, or maybe I'll go with 50. Set this to somewhere around there, and this one to somewhere around there. Okay, and I'll set the offset to 0. So now we have something like this, but I want the stroke to be right over here. So we can just play around with the offset. Not with the offset, the end property and the start property. So somewhere around this. Let's go a bit. Maybe let's go with 20%. And play around with the offset a bit to make it look really nice. Something like that. Yep, I think that is looking pretty good actually, as you can see. So basically we don't need the start property animation, we just need the end and the offset animation. Okay, that is looking pretty good. So this is gonna be line one, so let's rename this to line underscore 01. And then what I can do is just duplicate it by hitting Ctrl D on the keyboard and create a second shape. We can increase the stroke size to somewhere around there maybe. Yep, that looks pretty good to me. Maybe around 12 pixels. Let's go with 12 pixels. And now what I can do is hit U so we can see just the keyframes. Go right over here and play around with the offset a bit and also with the end property. So I'm going to set this to somewhere around there and just something like that. So you can see we have something like this. Pretty simple to do, and we can go ahead and add more and more lines and, you know, strokes like this to make it look even more complex. So I'm gonna create one more, make sure the current time indicator is at the keyframes so we don't mess up with the keyframes. So we can just tweak the offset a bit, maybe I'll place it somewhere on there, you know, make it look really nice and cool. You can even make them longer if you want to. So now we have something like this, you can see. Now the animation is pretty stiff at the moment, but we will fix it later on. So yep, I'm happy with that, looks pretty good to me. And now what I can do is I can go ahead and select the pen tool, and I'm gonna create a different kind of shape this time. So I'm gonna set this to around, let's go with 15 pixels. And right over here, I'm gonna hold shift and create a stroke just like this. Maybe I'll move this a bit down using the arrow keys. Go to contents, shape 1, and transform shape 1, and set this to 35 as well, just like we did before, and just place it in the position that we want. So I'm gonna place it somewhere around there, maybe a bit more. Just take your time and try to be as precise as you can, because these are the details that are gonna make our composition look really, really good. So let's rename this to something like, let's call this line underscore 04, and go ahead and add a trim path to this. So let's go to add and trim path and animate this up really simply, just like that. I'm gonna go to somewhere around there, create a keyframe at the end property, setting it to 0. 2 seconds maybe, or maybe 10 seconds, or 2 seconds and 10 frames. Let's set this to 100. And then what I can do is, just like that, yeah, pretty good. Then what I can do is just duplicate it by hitting Ctrl D on the keyboard. And all I need to do is increase the stroke holding just like that. So now we have something like this, but this time I'm gonna move this up a little bit. So hit V, just move it up right over here. So now we have two shapes, and all I need to do is go into contents, go into shape one and stroke one, and just click on this icon which says add dashes. So let's click on it. So it's gonna add dashes just like that. So we can increase or decrease the number of dashes that we want. So I'm gonna keep it to somewhere around there. So now we have a really cool look, as you can see. So maybe I'll just select this, hit U, and maybe just drag this a bit back in time, somewhere around there. Let's see what we have. And maybe I'll just play around with the timing a bit. So I want this to start after animation of this shape. So I'll just place it somewhere around there. Yep, pretty cool. Let's select it and hit F9 to ease these keyframes and go to graph editor and create a curve which looks something like that. So now we have, okay, that is not looking good on this dashes. So I'm gonna select this and hit F9. And let's add a curve on this shape only, something like that. Okay, looks pretty good. Maybe increase the time a bit. Let's select the keyframes, hit U so we can see all the keyframes. And select this keyframes, hit F9, go to graph editor and create a curve like so. So let's see what we have. Okay, this is looking pretty good. You can displace them a bit to give it a bit more complexity, I can say. Maybe around displacement of 10 frames, I guess. Okay, this is looking pretty good. Now let's add one more line, I think. I'll add one more shape. So what I can do is I can basically just select this line, hit ctrl D to duplicate it, and just bring this right over there. Set the stroke to 2 pixels, or maybe, yep, 2 pixels looks good. Let's bring this down using the arrow keys. There we go. And what I can do is basically set this to 2. Go to contents, shape 1 and strokes. So now we don't need the dash strokes. So I'm gonna set this to minus. So we have a plain stroke just like that. First of all, let's bring this down a little bit, so we have some space for our stroke. There we go. And select the pen tool and just move this somewhere around there and hit V. Just move this point somewhere around there, just to add a bit more detail into our lower third, something like that. Maybe I'll just move this a bit down. Perfect. So now we have something like that. Now it's a little bit of, you know, detail, but it's gonna take us a long way because it looks really, really good, as you can see. Perfect. Hit Ctrl D, and now we can just rotate this up, I guess. I don't think the rotation would work, but let's try it out. Maybe I'll just set this to 180 degrees. Okay, let's place it in the position that we want. Let's drag it up just like that and use the arrow keys to be a bit more precise. Okay, perfect. That looks good to me. Now it's looking a bit more nice and complex. So now what I can do is make sure to select the lines just like that and pre-comp them. Let's call this lines. So I'm gonna hit Ctrl D to duplicate it, and then maybe I can just rotate this up. Let's see if that works. Hit R to bring down rotation properties and rotate this up just like that to 180 degrees, something like that. One thing that we need to do is cut these lines from right over here. So hit Ctrl X to cut and hit Ctrl V to paste it up in the main scene. So we have something like that. Now, as you can see, looks really, really cool and nice. Yeah, that is looking pretty good. But as you can see, we need to fix some of the stuff. So we can go into accents, or the lines, not the accents. Select the layer, and maybe I'll just increase the stroke to around 14 pixels. And this one, let's go and set this to 16 pixels. Let's see what we have. Looks pretty good. Let's go into lines and set the color to white. need to select it and set this to white color, this one to white as well, hang this one to white, set this one to white, and set this one to white as well. Okay, that is looking pretty good. Let's set this strokes to white as well. So yep, that is I guess looking pretty good. Maybe I'll just move this strokes a bit up so that it can match up with the other strokes. See, yep, now it's looking just perfect. Maybe I'll just play around with this lines a bit. Yep, as you can see, this is looking really really nice. Yep, I'm happy with that. Now what I can do is select the plane and pre-comp it. Let's call this base and hit ctrl D to create two copies and set the or rename this to matte. And now what we can do is go ahead and add in any text that you want. I'm just gonna type in digital lower thirds. Okay, just set this in the center and let's select a really cool font, maybe an Evagria. Set this to italic. Maybe I'll just bring this really close and make this small a bit, something like that. Perfect. Let's make this a bit small. Okay, bring this below the matte composition and set the transfer, the track matte, to alpha matte. So now we have something like this, really cool and nice. And you can anytime, you know, change the color of the base. You can add a fill, maybe, you know, give it some really nice colors, maybe a blue one or something like that, whichever that you want. I'm gonna set this to white for now and change the color of the text to something like a gray. And there we go. That's how you can create a really nice, cool and digital looking lower third in After Effects. So I hope this tutorial was helpful to you, and let's wrap it up for today. So I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care and thank you so much for watching, guys.